Welcome back to another VTScada training video. If your application includes many similar things, whether that's motors, pumps, stations, or whatever, and if there needs to be a page to control or monitor each one individually, well then rather than create a separate page for each, just create a parameterized page that can be used by all. One note before we start. While parameterized pages are good by themselves, they're better if you also add user-defined tag types, tag widgets, and some basic expressions. Therefore, this video is just one in a series. We begin with basic parameters and navigation tools. Let's start with a blank page in the Idea Studio. For this example, make it a pop-up page, although that's not a requirement. Say yes to adding it to the menu. Set the page size, since that's a normal step for a pop-up, and put a label in the middle using the text tool. I'm going to adjust the size of that just to make it a bit easier to see. To make this a parameterized page, open the Page Properties ribbon, then click the Manage Parameters tool. In the Manage dialog, click the Add button. A parameter must have a name, which can be any word, but try to make it a bit different from any word you've used elsewhere. It's a good idea to add a description, so do that. The choice of type is important. Now, if the plan is to use this page to show tags, then you'll need a parameter for each. The type must be set to tag, and the kind of tag must be chosen. But for this example, the parameter is a label, so text is the correct type. After saving the parameter, note that you can edit or you can add more, but there is no delete button. It's not impossible to delete parameters, but doing so means editing code, so we won't do that today. In effect, the page now has an invisible bucket named PPageLabel. To make that useful, you'll need two things. A way to put something into the parameter bucket every time someone opens the page, and a way to pour the contents of the parameter bucket into something on the page. One extra step isn't required, but it's a good idea to do anyway. Put something into the parameter just for while you're working in the Idea Studio. This doesn't set a default. It just lets you see what you're doing while working. Now let's pour the contents of a parameter bucket into that label. Open the properties of the text. Expand the data source menu by the word text. Choose the parameters option. In the parameter drop-down list, choose PPageLabel. The content of the label now shows the value that's in the parameter, but only while working in the Idea Studio. All that remains is to choose what to put into the parameter whenever someone opens the page. That's done with navigation tools or the menu. In the page menu, note that page 1 doesn't seem to have any text. And if you try to open the page, you'll be prompted for a value to put into the parameter bucket. That's not user-friendly. So cancel, close the empty page. Now right-click on the page menu item, the preview in the page menu, to open the properties dialog. Note that what you're editing is the menu item that opens the page. That's not the same thing as the page itself. Click the Set Parameters button and type something for PPageLabel. It would be helpful if the menu item indicated what's in the parameter, so click Specify Label. Type a label that matches and click OK. Before opening this, let's add another menu link to the page by copying. Select the page, set the parameter, and change the label. And now you have a working parameterized page with a different message depending on how you open it. One more refinement. It would be good for the page title to match the content. Back to the Idea Studio in the Page Properties ribbon. Open the Title tool, click the expression box. This expression is going to just be the parameter. You could make it fancy by using some string handling functions. And if the parameter was a tag rather than text, you would have to specify which property of that tag to show. But for this example, the parameter is text, so that's all you need for the title. You now have a basic parameterized page, but a typical page will have many widgets, not just a label. You could create a parameter for each, but it's better to create a user-defined tag and a matching tag widget. So take a few minutes to watch the rest of the videos in this series before you start building your pages. And as always, there's more information to be found in the documentation.
Thank you.